extensive detailed understanding. The document we received at the weekend gives us a detailed understanding. I want to highlight things that members may be able to look at in the next few weeks, as I mentioned there. There is reference in section 111 to a working party, which is described as a promising development. Suggests there is still some openness on behalf of the council. There is a discussion about allowing young people to stay on to be a 2 to 19 in school. But one of the key issues raised in this was the numbers of children at a school who need and use wheelchairs. 18 is mentioned in the document. The issue concerning parents was the question of space. And in one particular chapter, they also talk about the needs in section 623. They give a detailed breakdown of the needs that the children have there for help with movement, children who have epilepsy, children dependent on oxygen, and others 16 who receive time-consuming gastrostomy feeding. A whole range of issues raised by the parents, which were touched on at the two consultation meetings that I attended. And I have to concur with Councillor Hayes' description of some of the manner in which some of their questions were fielded. I felt that parents who got detailed knowledge data, the knowledge of their children, somehow got the impression that officers didn't understand their viewpoint. There is a phrase in this document on chapter 837.4 to describe the parents as battled weary. It talks of them being grief-stricken and tired. This process has lasted many months, and it may be September when it's resolved. We have done our utmost to look at it in the needs of the children and avoid political problems about it. But I have to say, a few weeks ago, I read documents that said there was an attack on disabled people, and a further document that said there was an attack on vulnerable disabled people. I leave members to reflect on the quality of those publications. But I asked the school's budget in 2013-2014 for high needs. 31.7 million in 2013, 32.2 million in 2014.
So, maybe more time, Councillor.
So, those 30 minutes.
I believe the funding is there. The issue is the funding formula that the Wirral has chosen to adopt. The letters from parents talked about the families are feeling under great strain at this time, worrying about having to send their children to schools that they know won't be suitable for them. The documents refer, and the victims refer to the SEN test. The document from parents talks about the SEN test and the rules from 2007. We often hear the test referred to repeatings. Unless the officers and members of who have looked at it in the executive come up with a clear view that the test is actually being met, then it is difficult to see how parents can be convinced. Finally, Mr. Mayor, reference has been made to the guidance issue tonight. As I see it, council is expressing an opinion. It is the executive who are taking the decision. Executive members who choose not to vote at all this evening when the member stands in their name. Council wishes to express a view. Hope the executive members take it on board.
Right, I have two more speakers of the Democrats. Given the proportionality within the chamber, I will be leaning to take the time to decide which one of you want to speak, and I'm not sure all second, because no one has a second.
I'll speak now.
Very democratic of you. Of course, it's democratic of me. I'm in your chair, that's the end of the chair. As you quite know quite well, the way the process works, it's those people that stand. And if none of your colleagues can stand to speak in this debate, then that's their favourite. We should allow both of us to address the
council. You should know, Dave, I
don't
give you any advice about the
chair. I'm explaining the way the system works.
Would you like to make a contribution rather than be
proportionate. You say it's proportionate. Proportionate is that none of your members stood up, so the ones that stand up should be allowed to address the council.
I just go out and say, our group has no objection to vote for the Democrats meeting. If our members are still up, we don't believe the course that we've played part. It's too set up to speak for that.
I'm sorry, but if this is the daily test of know members have, a lot of members have received a copy of the Burton's response to the consultation. I recommend everybody read every page of this and absorb every part of it, because it absolutely rips to shreds the proposal put forward by this council. It actually deals with the real issue. The issue is the children. It's nothing to do with schools or funding, because funding doesn't matter. Funding in education is all there. It's been set by governments. It's never been taken away. We have air cuts, this, that, and other. You know, it's not the case in education. The funding's been there. It's the way the funding has been divvied out by the cabinets of this council. That's one of the problems that we've got. I'm really concerned about the consultation itself, in the way that parents asked questions of officers and didn't get responses until the last day of the consultation taking place. As Paul quite rightly said, how do they respond to something so quickly like that? They're not getting a reply. So I want people to take real notes of what the parents are saying, because they're the ones who've got all the answers. Thank you, Mr.
very sincere feelings around that, and I'm sure everybody does that, and I'm disappointed as a new councillor I don't understand why the Labour Group isn't engaging with the debate at all. And just on the point of the consultation, I just wanted to raise one issue that some time ago, about 18 months ago, there was a letter put up from the Leader of the Council about the local elections and why his group, it was during the what really matters consultation process. And part of that was whether local elections should be moved to once every 4 years. Okay, so it's nothing to do with this debate, but during that, in that letter, the way
it's nothing to do with this debate, you keep
no, 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 yeah, well, I mean, the point I'm making will do. It, he said that the reason for bringing forward his recommendation about was, and I quote, that early analysis of the consultation results shows that 91% of the people who responded supported the change. So in that particular instance, he was prepared to bring forward the recommendation before the consultation had finished. And I think that the parents and everybody involved in their school would like to know why their situation is really any different.
We have held consultation now because